Hi, tarot friends. It's Jade here with Tarot Your Truth, and I'm here with a fun tag. This one was created by FablesDen. I saw it on Deevination's channel, and both of those you should, if you don't know them, you should definitely check them out. I'll see if I can, if I remember, I'll link them below, both the Instagram where this original tag or zombie story came from, and then also Dee's channel, who used to be Art and Tarot by Dee and now is Deevination. So this is a fun tag. I saw Dee's and I just had to jump in. So it is called, read you what the FablesDen said in her Instagram story. This is the end. Zombie apocalypse tarot spread. It's Halloween and she made this fun spread to see what our zombie story is, should the zombie apocalypse chance upon us. I also she also started a YouTube challenge or tag on her channel, and so that's what I'm going to I will tag this to that as well. Let's have a look here. Okay, I'm just going to, sorry, I'm using the zombie tarot, which I edged in different colors of flesh, orangey brown, brighter orange, and brown. So I'm actually going to shuffle this off camera just because it's a lot easier to do it that way. So there are five cards in this. So it's kind of the story, and the cards will, I guess the cards will tell me how my story ends up in a zombie apocalypse. Let's have a look here. So, the first card is the end is here. What happens on your first day in the zombie apocalypse? All right, let's pull one card. I'll just pull a single card every time. Okay, one card. What happens on your first day in the zombie apocalypse? And the first card is, oh, let's try putting it in. So the seven of swords. And I guess on the first day of the zombie apocalypse, I'm going to do pretty well. I'll throw everyone else under the bus. My family is safe upstairs in the bedrooms, and everyone else is fair game, I guess. You don't need to outrun the zombies, right? You only need to outrun the slowest person, or in this case, have the higher ground and give the zombies something to distract them while my family gets away. All right. I'll put that card there. All right, so card two is, so I'm doing all right on the first day. Maybe, you know, we're not talking about ethics here or what I actually would do, but okay. So the second card is an immediate challenge. What stops you from getting what you want in your zombie tale? All right, so what I want is to protect my family, which is why they're all safe upstairs. Okay, so card two. Card two is the Hermit. So again, this is an immediate challenge. What stops you? Whoa. What stops you from getting what you want in your zombie tale? So what I want is to protect my family. And I guess the hordes are beating in. We're not sure how long we can stay in this safe room. I'm trying to see what it says on her book. I'm not 100% sure. But They're beating down. So I'm not sure how long, you know, there's a clock there. I'm not sure how long we can stay in this safe haven. So how long my family can be safe will depend on how many people I can throw down the stairs at them. And, you know, maybe just some internal thoughts. I don't know. That is an interesting one. I will have some struggles internally about throwing people down the stairs, but Mama Bear's out, so everyone else can just go to the zombies. All right, it's card. I'm not sure what this is saying about me right now, but so far it looks like we're safe. My family is safe, and the only thing against me right now is time. Do we have enough food in our safe haven? I don't know. I guess it depends on how much warning we had. So the third card is your darkest moment. This is when some ultimate shit goes down. All right, so what is my darkest moment? Oh boy, okay. The King of Cups. So my darkest moment. My darkest moment is maybe my husband got zombified, and I don't know how I'm going to protect my family on my own. I still love him. I don't want him to die. I also do want to protect my family. So it is the rest of my family. So it is going to be, I would see that being a pretty dark moment. Being completely torn in different directions. Do I protect my kids from being zombified? Do I, decapitate my, you know, the person that I love who now has been zombified? I don't know. That's definitely a darkest moment for me. All right, so the next question, I'm going to keep shuffling here, is your path to light. How do you rise after you fall? How do you triumph? Path to light. How do you rise after you fall? How do you triumph? All right. The Nine of Wands. Well, I guess I triumph. Similar to Dee, I'm going to say that I triumph by, if you can't beat them, join them. That's really it. So if that was supposed to be, you know, he's wearing a different cat, but if this is my hubby, then maybe I just say, you know what, let's deal. I can't, there's no way that I could kill him, so let's join him and see, you know, let's join the other side and protect our family that way. All right. I don't know if these are all the people I threw down the stairs or not. All right. And the last question is, the end is also the beginning. What is your ultimate fate? Still alive? Still human? Well, clearly it doesn't look like I'm still human, because it looks like I'm just joining the hordes there. But let's see what this says. Maybe the zombie virus won't take effect for me. Let's just move these over a bit. Or here. All right. So what is my ultimate fate? Oh boy. The Four of Wands. So it looks like my entire family has joined. So we've got maybe my two kids, my husband and I, so our entire family. We've just joined. We're celebrating with some cake and some femurs, maybe. So definitely not all still human. We've decided to join the other side in the fight against the humans. And we are having a pretty good time right now. So that was the zombie story hashtag. It was a pretty fun. It's a pretty fun story. I think I would repeat this one for sure, just for fun, maybe with my kids. I hope you have enjoyed this. I hope you try this as well. If you do, please do a video response as well, and I would love to see more of them. It's a pretty fun one. I love this deck. Anyway, thank you to Fables Den and to D from Deevination for doing these tags and the video response, because they were a lot of fun. Mine was pretty boring. D was much more hilarious. And if you haven't said, like I said, if you haven't seen it, then I'll see if I can link it down below. But I hope you enjoyed this. It's just a nice, quick, short, fun break today. And if you do enjoyed it, please do hit the like and subscribe button. I'd greatly appreciate it. Thank you so much. Bye.